Hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB 247 where we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for the ESI section of RBI Grade B and NABARD. So let's begin with the session guys, but before we begin, if you are new here, do subscribe to our channel. If you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon so that you can receive all the notification regarding the latest videos, and also you can join this Telegram group फॉर डेली क्विजेज. यहाँ पे डेली क्विजेज आते हैं जो कि बहुत ज्यादा बेनिफिशियल है. सो डू जॉइन दिस. सो नाउ लेट्स बिगिन विद द वेरी फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन. विच ऑर्गेनाइजेशन और डिपार्टमेंट और मिनिस्ट्री हैज ऑर्गेनाइज्ड प्रारंभ स्टार्टअप इंडिया इंटरनेशनल समिट. सो दिस प्रारंभ स्टार्टअप इंडिया इंटरनेशनल समिट गाइज वॉज हेल्ड ऑन 15th and 16th January 2021 एंड इट वॉज ऑर्गेनाइज बाई डिपार्टमेंट फॉर प्रमोशन ऑफ इंडस्ट्री एंड इंटरनल ट्रेड विच मीन्स विच इन शॉर्ट इज DPIIT. ऑलराइट, so let's discuss about this summit more. So as I told you, it was held on 15th and 16th January 2021, and what was the purpose of this summit? So this was basically guys a follow up of the announcement that was made by our Prime Minister at the BIMSTEC summit in the year 2018, where India committed that they will organize the BIMSTEC startup conclave. Okay, BIMSTEC स्टार्टअप कॉन्क्लेव को ऑर्गेनाइज करने का कमिटमेंट किया गया था फ्रॉम अवर प्राइम मिनिस्टर एट द BIMSTEC समिट दैट वाज हेल्ड इन काठमांडू 2018. उसी के फॉलोअप के लिए दिस समिट वाज ऑर्गेनाइज एंड देयरफॉर द फर्स्ट डे दैट इज द 15th January 2021, द फर्स्ट डे ऑफ दिस समिट वाज डिवोटेड टू दिस BIMSTEC स्टार्टअप कॉन्क्लेव. ऑलराइट, and as I told you, it was organized by DPIIT and it was inaugurated by Commerce and Industry Minister, who is currently Mr. Piyush Goyal, and he is also the Minister of Consumer Affairs and Food and Public Distribution. He is also the Minister of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution. After the death of Ram Vilas Paswan, he was given this additional charge. Right, and as I told you, the first day of the summit was devoted to host this BIMSTEC startup conclave, and the summit marked the 5th anniversary of the Startup India that was launched in the year 2016. 2016 mein Startup India ko launch kiya gaya tha. Uska 5th anniversary complete ho gaya hai. To mark that 5th anniversary of this Startup India, this summit was organized. Alright. So I hope guys this news is clear, and now let's come back to the question. So I hope you can easily answer it now. Which organization has organized it? So it's Department of Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade, which works under the Ministry of Commerce and Industry. And moving ahead to the question number 2. Consider the following statement regarding modified scheme to enhance ethanol distillation capacity, and you have to identify the correct statement. So this scheme, there was a scheme guys to for ethanol distillation capacity, and this scheme has been modified now. Now you have to identify the correct statement regarding that modified scheme. All right, so let's discuss this. And question number 3 is also based on this scheme. And okay, so the Ministry of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution has launched a modified scheme for ethanol distillation capacity with an objective to enhance the ethanol distillation capacity in the country. Hamare desh mein jo ethanol distillation capacity hai usko enhance karne ke liye, and also for setting up of distilleries for producing first generation ethanol from feedstock. Feedstock se first generation ethanol banane ke liye, distilleries ko set up karne ke liye, This scheme has been modified by the Ministry of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution. All right. So remember both the objectives. Number one objective is what? Enhancement of ethanol distillation capacity. Then we have setting up of distilleries for producing first generation ethanol from the feedstock. And what are these feedstock? Like we have cereals, we have sugarcane, etc. Okay. And these are the financial assistance that will be provided to the applicants, that will be provided to the beneficiaries. Jo bhi iske beneficiaries honge, unko kuch financial assistance hai, wo di jayegi through this scheme. And this financial assistance guys will be provided for setting up of distilleries and or for the expansion of the existing distilleries. Jo already existing distilleries hai, unko expand karne ke liye ya fir nai distilleries banane ke liye, the financial assistance will be provided. And in what form this financial assistance will be provided? So it will be provided guys in the form of interest subvention for 5 years, and this includes 1 year moratorium also. This includes what? 1 year moratorium. Okay, so 5 year ka isme total interest subvention milega at the rate of 6% per annum ya fir 50% of the rate of interest charged by the banks. And on what amount this interest subvention scheme is being provided, yeah, will be provided. So this will be provided guys on the loans which they have taken, okay, which they have taken from the banks. Unke against interest subvention will be provided by the government through this scheme, all right. And this will bring an investment of around rupees 40,000 crore. It is estimated that this move will bring an investment of 40,000 crore in this sector, all right. Now, what will be the benefit of the scheme? Why government is doing all this? So this scheme, guys, would definitely help in achieving the blending targets of ethanol with petrol. And what is the target? 10% blending of ethanol in with petrol by the year 2022, while 20% blending of ethanol with petrol by the year 2025. And remember, earlier this target was 2030, but now it has been preponed to 2025. All right, and it will help in reducing the import dependency on crude oil, of course, and it will definitely increase the farmers' income. Okay, farmers' ki income ko bhi increase karega because the demands of their crops will increase, because we are setting up distilleries which will produce first generation ethanol from the feedstock. And of course, feedstocks are what? Cereals and sugarcane, which will boost the demand of crops of farmers, thereby increasing their income. All right. So this was about the scheme, and now let's come back to question number 2 and 3. So I hope, guys, now you can answer these questions. So you have to identify the correct statements in tino mein se. It has been launched by Ministry of Food Processing Industry. So is that Ministry of Food Processing Industry? No, that's Ministry of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution, which means the statement is incorrect. Interest subvention at the rate of 6% per annum will be provided for setting up of distilleries. Yes, this is absolutely correct. Either 6% per annum or 50% of the interest rate that has been charged by the banks on the loans. All right, this statement is absolutely correct. And rupees 40,000 crore investment is expected after the implementation of the scheme. Yes, this is absolutely correct. 40,000 crore ka investment ka expectation hai, which means option B, only 2 and 3 will be the correct answer. Okay, and what is question number 3? What is the target of blending of ethanol with petrol by 2025? So as I told you, by 2022 the target is 10%, while by 2025 the target is how much? 20%. So therefore option D, 20% here, will be the correct answer. And now let's move on to question number 4. Recently, a new institute, which is CSIR NISCPR. And what is this NISCPR? It's National Institute of Science and Policy Research. National Institute of Science and Policy Research. So do remember the full form also, guys, because that's a very brand new institute that has been launched. So it has been inaugurated by Dr. Harshvardhan, who is of course the Minister of Health and Family Welfare. He is also the Minister of Earth Science, and he is also the Minister of Science and Technology. And now, can you tell me where is the Lok Sabha constituency of Dr. Harshvardhan? Write down in the comments. By merging two institutes, so which of the following are the two institutes? So this institute, guys, has been established by merging two existing institutes of CSIR. So you have to tell the name of those two institutes. So let me tell you the name. The name of the two institutes are National Institute of Science Communication and Information Resources, and another one is National Institute of Science Technology and Development Studies. So these two institutes have now been merged, and ek naya institute ban gaya hai jiska naam hai National Institute of Science Communication and Policy Research. So here the correct answer should be 2 and 4, which means option E, 2 and 4 should be the correct answer. And who is the president of CSIR? It's the Honorable Prime Minister of our country. And who is the Vice President? Is the Union Home Minister. And now, can you tell me the name of Director of CSIR? Maine aapko pehle bhi bataya hai, write down in the comments. The name of Director of CSIR. President, it's Prime Minister. Vice President, it's Union Home Minister. Now, you have to tell me the name of Director. Alright. And guys, that's it for the session. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. And thank you so much for watching. Milte hain kal ke session mein. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.